All right, here's a word problem. A special treat is made by mixing 5 pounds of popcorn, costing 80 cents a pound, with caramel costing 2.40 a pound. How many pounds of caramel are needed to make a mixture that costs 1.40 a pound? So what we want is draw a little picture of what's going on here. We are going to mix some popcorn, right, with some caramel. We're going to put it all into a big mixture over here. All right, so this is basically the amount. We're going to write inside each vat the amount we're putting in there, and underneath we're going to put down the cost per pound. And to avoid decimals, I'm going to do everything in cents. If you like working with decimals and you have a calculator, it's just as easy to write everything in terms of dollars and cents. All right, so for the popcorn, do we know how many pounds of popcorn we have? Well, I see that right here that we've got 5 pounds of popcorn and it costs 80 cents a pound. So that tells me a lot of information. I know I have 5 pounds and I know it's 80 cents a pound and I'm doing it in cents. So I'm just going to put 80. So we really know exactly how much we're paying for the popcorn, right? 5 times 80 cents. It's going to be $4 or 400 cents. Now, what about the caramel? So we've got, what about the caramel? Caramel costs 2.40 a pound. So I know how much it costs, but it doesn't tell me how many pounds, does it? It says how many pair. Oh, that's what I don't know. There's always something we don't know, right? So we know that to how much caramel? Well, how about we just put C so we remember it's the caramel. If you like to use X, that is perfectly fine. Okay, but how much is that caramel per pound? 2.40. I did everything in cents, so I want to put 2.40. Now, remember, the cost per pound in the mixture is not 80 plus 240. It's somewhere in between, and we don't know what that number is exactly unless it's given. In this case, it's $1.40 per pound. So it's somewhere in between. You don't know exactly. You might notice that, let's see, 140 is closer to 240 than it is to 80, isn't it? So it looks like we might have a little bit more of the caramel. We'll see. How much is in the mixture? Well, I'm putting in 5 pounds plus C, whatever that number is. So 5 plus C, or I like to write that as C plus 5, but you can write 5 plus C as well. Now, what we want to make sure is that if I bought the two vats separately, in other words, if I bought the popcorn at 80 cents a pound and I bought the caramel at 2.40 per pound and I mixed it myself, it would be the same price as if I simply bought a mixture, the same number of pounds total at $1.40 a pound. So what I'm going to do is find out how much I pay for the popcorn. I've got 5 pounds, 80 cents a pound. So I could put 80 times 5 or 5 times 80. It's really up to you. I'm going to do it in terms of the amount times how many pounds. So I'm going to write as 80 times 5. All right, so that's the cost per pound, and I had 5 pounds. And that's how much I pay for the popcorn, but I also have to pay for the caramel. And I've got C pounds, so it's 240 per pound, so it's going to be 240 times C. And that should be the same as if I just bought the whole thing at $1.40 per pound. So C plus 5 pounds at $1.40. Make sure you put the C plus 5 in parentheses. Okay? If you want, you could put the C over here in parentheses. And notice if you add what's in parentheses, the 5 and the C together, that's what ends up being in the parentheses over here. That's up to you. So now we want to solve this equation. So I have 80 times 5. So remember, this equation is talking about the total cost of the mixture, whether I bought the two amounts separately or just bought it all in one big mixture. So I've got 80 times 5 is 400 plus 240C And I'm going to do the distributive property over here. 140c plus 140 times 5 is 700. And now I'm going to get the variables on one side and the constants on the other side. So I've got 240c on the left, so let's put everything on the left-hand side. So I'm going to subtract 140c from both sides. Okay. And then I'll go ahead and subtract 400 from both sides at the same time. So that on the left-hand side of the equation, I have 100c. And on the right-hand side of the equation, I have 300. And then we could just divide both sides by 100. And that should tell us what C is, to only use 3 pounds. Earlier I said this backwards. Since 140 is actually closer to 80, it means we're going to probably use more popcorn, which notice we do. We're going to use 5 pounds of popcorn, and it looks like 3 pounds of caramel. But we want to make sure that's correct. So I'm going to say, I hope this is the answer. Use 3 pounds of the caramel. But you definitely want to check your answer. So I'm going to assume this is correct, and we will erase it if it doesn't check out. All right, this is what we started with, and I'm now putting it out in dollars and cents since that's what was in the original problem. And now we know what C is. So we could draw the picture a little bit different to check. This is still 5, and we know it's 80 cents a pound. That was for the popcorn. And we know we're mixing that with, remember that we got C was equal to 3 when we solved it? So we now know there's actually 3 pounds of the caramel. And that was 240 a pound. Now, if you're mixing 5 pounds with 3 pounds, how much is in the mixture? 5 plus 3, you've got 8 pounds in here. And that was $1.40 a pound. So the check will be, is the amount of money I pay for the popcorn and caramel separately, the total cost, is that going to be the same as if I just bought the entire mixture at $1.40 per pound? So let's check that out. 5 times 80 cents, and it doesn't matter if you do 0.80 times 5 or 5 times 0.80, and we're going to have $2.40 for the 3 pounds. The big question, is that the same thing as if I just bought it all at $1.40? So I bought all 8 pounds at $1.40. Okay, so now we just do this. 0.80 times 5, that was $4. So we had $4 for this amount for the popcorn, is what we paid. And then we have 240 times 3, that's $7.20. Okay, so let's add that up. If I bought the mixture, I mean, if I bought the two amounts separately, I would end up paying $11.20. Now, is that the same as just buying all 8 pounds at $1.40 per pound? Yes, it is. If you multiply that out, it's also $11.20. So our answer was correct. Now, another way I sometimes like to write the check out is I might just say for the popcorn, you've got 5 pounds at 80 cents. And you say, all right, that's $4. Caramel, you've got 3 pounds at 240. And that's 720, and then you just get to add it up. See how easy that is? And then what you're going to do is check that against the mixture, would just be 8 pounds at 240, and that also is 1120, right? So you could match it up that way. So somehow you want to write down that you understand what you're really checking here, that if you buy the popcorn separately and the caramel separately, it's the same as if you bought the full mixture. And you can see the 5 plus 3 adds up to 8 here, but the, oops, I did that wrong. That was 8 times $1.40. I did the arithmetic right, but wrote 2.40. So 8 pounds at $1.40 is also 11.20. So it checks out, and therefore this is correct. We're going to use 3 pounds of caramel.